Thank you very much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Today, two AFC teams set to do battle, as we've got a good one in store between the Pittsburgh Steelers and the New England Patriots. They met here on the opening Thursday of 2015, and they're at it again here. The Steelers and Pats are underway. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line.
That you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter because he has
the ball popped in the air and intercepted, picked off by Ryan Shazier, and they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line.
This interception would go on the record of the quarterback, but as a receiver, you've got to understand where you are in the field. Middle portion, you know it's going to come in hot, square your body to the quarterback, and be ready to make the catch.
And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Now a carry for the veteran. This is D'Angelo Williams. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down. And the D-line pinching together must be expecting the run. They'll fake the give to Williams. Now it's Roethlisberger. And he's got his big tight end over the middle, complete. He got 29 yards that time.
There are so many things to watch for when you play defense. And reading your keys, you always hear about that, and having your eyes in the right place. Sometimes your eyes can fool you. How about that play action there? It sprang the big guy, didn't it?
Able to dump it over the top to him. And he's going to take this one down to the 25. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on second and short.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yard.
Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Offense in a good spot here, second and two. They run it again with Williams. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. Just a gain of a yard there, and now it'll be third down. A quick look here at the Patriot defense.
It seems like whenever people talk about Chris Long, the number one thing they discuss is his motor and how relentless he is. Let's not forget, he's also a superior athlete.
And he will have the first before he's brought down right on the chalk of the 20.
Third and one, partner. No need to be fancy there. Just use some force and move forward and pick up the first down.
They go play action here on first down.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
And here comes play number six on this drive. Second and 10 now. It's Roethlisberger. And he's going to drop this off to Williams. Complete. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. It's a nice pickup of 12 yards, and it gives him a first and goal.
We always talk about having to read defenses and how complicated that is. Well, this was an excellent read. Read the pressure and got rid of the football before it even got to him for a nice game.
And when they're blitzing like that, running back usually a good spot to go with the football?
Without a doubt, because he's right in your sight line or he's near you. So you're able to just get it to him easily. And once he gets in space, that's usually a good matchup for him.
No gain on the play that time, but it sets up second and goal. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom! Quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
Now Roethlisberger throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. give him 7 on the play, and that is going to set up 3rd and goal.
I know most of the time when the ball's in the air, you're thinking wide receiver, tight end, but running backs, they can be a big part of any passing offense nowadays.
This defense hasn't let them in yet. They'll need to stiffen here. 3rd and goal from the 2. Trying for Brown, and it's intercepted. Devin McCourty picks it off. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. Out comes the New England offense to see what they can do this time. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. And really just a heck of a catch. That's a really good receiver making a nice play.
And against a really good defensive back. Right there together and over the top, the receiver wins the battle.
Garoppolo over the middle, it's Amendola. And down he'll go at the 25. It's a 4-yard pickup, and that'll bring up 2nd down. This is the offense we're going to see coming up in this one, and LeGarrette Blount, the featured back.
The big knock on him coming out of college was his lack of speed, but it's definitely not his lack of power. He runs right through opposing tacklers and sets things up big for his offense.
4 yards on the pickup, and that's going to lead to a 3rd down. Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Patriots in possession to begin quarter number 2. They're up against a 3rd and 2 to start things out.
Let's go! Green, 39!
They'll drop to throw. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Even in today's NFL, when we think of the tight end position now as really a glorified wide receiver, we're still asking a lot of those guys. They have to block as well, and every now and then, they don't come down with the football.
And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on 4th down, and they're going to go for it. Now with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout. That's their 2nd, so they'll have 1 remaining here in this 2nd quarter. We'll be right back. And how about the call here? They need 2 yards in their own territory on 4th down, and they're going to go for it.
All right, here we go.
They'll try and throw for it here. Got a man, and he hits him in stride. That'll be a gain of 16. And on 4th down, they're able to convert and move the sticks.
Mission accomplished on that throw. Slant, pick up the 1st down. I like how he just put it on the receiver and didn't lead him on that one.
Happened quickly. Defense, not much they could do. And the coach has decided to throw the red flag. He will challenge this play.
The head coach relied on his eagle eye in the sky to make the right call and was told to challenge it, and it looks like it's paid off.
And from a coach's standpoint, when you throw that flag, it's probably a pretty tense moment. Here it pays off.
Yeah, you have that little bit of indecision. You throw it where you feel like you're right, and then you think, uh-oh, did I get it right? In this case, they can celebrate.
It's a gain of 17 that time, and it'll be 1st down, New England. And now the passing game here in the 2nd quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Garoppolo now. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
So much of this game is focus and concentration. And whenever I see guys running the in route, I know that in the back of their mind, they're always wondering who's lurking inside that might put a big hit on them as they try and catch the ball.
And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Looking for Gronkowski, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Ryan Shazier. And they will take over at the 26-yard line. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Costly.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we've got a shot at points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you've got three on the board for sure, and to come away with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Yeah, will they make up for it? And they're able to get this one across the 35.
Really strong, effective run there out of a power set or a heavy set. Three tight ends in the game, and that's tough for a defensive coordinator. They want to spot that lineup coming into the game early so they can get the proper defensive personnel on the field. That's why the coordinator's relying on some of the assistants to tell him what offensive personnel is hitting the field so he can adjust accordingly. They weren't able to stop him on that run.
That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
And that play was what every defense is wary of. The big strike attempted downfield, but they were in excellent position. They didn't get fooled. And while he didn't come up with the interception, was able to bat the ball down.
So a second down incompletion now brings up third down. On third down, Roethlisberger toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down.
There's no doubt about it. That's just one of the best connections in the league. Big Ben throwing it to Antonio Brown. And Antonio Brown has turned himself into such a player. A low-round draft pick, but you can't beat his determination or work ethic. And Big Ben welcomes that.
And Big Ben won a Super Bowl at 23, youngest ever to do so, has never looked back. Time running out here on the play clock. Here's Ben, no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Jabal Sheard in there to sack him for a loss of six. Shift together here from the D-line. On second down, Roethlisberger. And down he goes. Jonathan Freeney in there to drop him, and sacks on first and second downs are going to lead to a third and long. And the O-line will have to do a better job protecting here on third down after that sack. Now Ben on third and long. He's going to fire one deep, and that's caught inside the 30. And that one results in 35 yards.
I know they had good coverage downfield, but you have to wonder, on third and long like that, how does that happen that they can get that far downfield and complete a pass? You got to guard the sticks, understand where you are, so it's almost like someone fell asleep at the switch. And now that the play's been completed, they've got to dust themselves off on defense, pick it up, and figure out how to not let that happen again. Frustrating for a defense, energizing for an offense. Finding a way to create that type of yardage in your running game, that'll make the guys carrying the ball very, very happy.
And it looks like this will likely be the last play before we hit the two-minute warning.
Let's see if they can sneak one more good play in before the two-minute signal.
On second down, here's Roethlisberger. Green's got it over the middle. A minute 59 to go in the first half. Back to Foxborough after this. Fresh set of downs here. Williams. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and nine.
A one-yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
And that one got tipped, kind of threw everything off. It brings up third.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion and both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering where it's going to go, good or bad for your team.
Hard throw, incomplete. So on fourth down, the Steelers call on the number of Chris Boswell for the field goal try. And he pushed it. Pushed it from short distance, wide right. It's no good. And this will remain a scoreless game. So it's a sloppy beginning for him. An interception on their opening drive and now a missed field goal here on drive number two.
Doesn't feel like they've shown up yet. It's been a very flat start. And against a team like this, you just can't let that happen.
Patrick!
Gronkowski, slot left.
Here we go now. 3-19! 3-19!
They go back to the air here after the INT. They'll tussle for it, and this is going to be caught. A good pick up there, 22. The last drive, he threw the pick, but he's not shy. He's going downfield again there.
And you can't be, because if you back off after throwing an interception, your whole game plan just goes right out the window, and it makes things easier for a defense. And you and I both know there isn't a quarterback in this league that's any good that doesn't throw an interception occasionally, and they usually bounce back in a big way. I've seen guys throw five and still find a way to win the game in the end.
Garoppolo looking deep now. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. They get 25 yards out of that one. And it gives the Pats a first down. And now a first down following that long gain. And a really good gain there on the post route. Partner, how do you know to go to that pass?
When you're running the ball effectively and the safety likes to dive up there to try and help tackle, that's when you want to hit him over the top of the post in the area he vacates. There are a good number of coaches that anytime they call an in route are really worried about the play because there's so much traffic ordinarily that the ball has to get through to get to the receiver. And on that play, it was batted down.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Danny Amendola, that was the intended target. And that's going to make it third down and 10. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. On third down, he'll drop to throw. And down he goes. They sack him back right around the 41-yard line. Now the Steelers put a stop to the action with a timeout defensively. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. Oh, it's a wobbler here. And the punt over the side in the air, and the spot will be inside the 35. The Steelers offense now, they get ready to head back on the field. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
On first down, it's Roethlisberger. And he's got his man on the out route. And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. And into the end zone. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Their dangerous wide receiver as the first half is winding down. And the Steelers have taken the lead. No, oh, he missed the PAT. No good on the extra point, so a letdown there. And this will stay a six-point ball game. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. Now the Patriot offense set to take over again. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Gronkowski, slot left.
Here we go. Green 39! Green 39!
Garoppolo now. He's got time in the pocket. Oh, nearly a disaster there on the check down. But they'll get it back.
He's got to be kicking himself right there. His team's already picked off two passes. That would have been the third in the game. And boy, they've really played well attacking the football.
Second and 10, he'll look to throw again. Incomplete, and we're down to 8 seconds now.
In many ways, being in a zone defense versus in-breaking routes is exactly what you want, because most zone coverages are taught to keep eyes on the quarterback and sense receivers, and that way you can see right back into the play, and when the quarterback delivers, you're just driving on the football and trying to arrive in a spot to make a play on it, which is exactly what we saw there.
And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. We have hit halftime. Still two more quarters to go. We'll take a timeout. We'll be back after this. You're watching the NFL, and it's on EA Sports.
It's in the game.
So both teams have their marching orders, and we'll get going again here in quarter number three. That's fielded in the end zone. He'll bring it back to just about the 25, call it the 24-yard line. The Steeler offense now with a football first here to begin the third quarter. They have the lead, now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ballgame.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. So now 11 yards to go for this offensive unit. It's second down. They come out here in the eye. Roethlisberger going to give to Williams on the draw. And he is going to lose yardage here. He lost two there, and it's third down.
Well, Brandon, so much for halftime adjustments. They still can't get anything going on the ground. It may be time to loosen things up and start flinging it around a little bit.
Extra defensive back out there now on third and 13. And the play clock's running down. To throw here, Roethlisberger. He gets it to Brown, complete. And he's going to have the first down, yardage to the 35.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
So the offense has it first and 10. Brown, the lone receiver, left. Now a play fake here on first down. Over the middle here to Brown. And he's brought down after a good gain. A very solid gain of 27. A good grab there by the former Central Michigan man, Antonio Brown.
And he ate up some real estate on the catch too, didn't he? I think the most impressive part of it, though, if there's a chance for him to get the football, even though he was covered well, he somehow finds a way to get it.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. Play clock winding down. On the ground, this is Williams. And they went the wrong way there, losing yardage back at the 43-yard line. So a loss of five, and it'll be second down. So the defense has put them in a tough spot. It's second and long. Not enough sense of urgency there. Play clock hits zero, 5-yard penalty.
Yeah, I like your point there. Not enough sense of urgency. People walking up to the line of scrimmage. You've got to get up there and get set and be ready to go.
They come out here in the eye. Here's Roethlisberger to throw. And he will find his man on the end route. Complete. And he's brought down after a good game. Charles, you think Big Ben is happy to have Antonio Brown on the other side of his passes?
You know he is, but he also expects it. And this is how their offense runs best. When those two get together, especially early, and continue to do it throughout the game, the end result is the one we're seeing right now. They're ahead on the board.
It has been early and often. Now Williams. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. That's going to go as a loss of two, and it'll be second down.
The defense won that play so fast that I think if the running back even had time to notice if anyone was there, it was just a blink of an eye, and there was a loss on the play.
Brown, the lone receiver, left. On second down, here's Roethlisberger. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. Antonio Brown, a 24-yard touchdown. And the Steelers find a way to stretch their lead. So they're going to go for two.
Here we go.
Roethlisberger looking to throw. And they're going to get to him. A sack. Sack back at the 9-yard line. Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Fielded about a yard deep. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the stop defensively. Now a chance really to set the tone here in quarter three.
They can really take charge, can't they? And this is probably how it was drawn up at the half. I think we can go inside the locker room, all right? And I think we would see up on the grease boards, stop them defensively, get the ball back for the offense, and let's go downfield and score. Seems simple, right? The last part, we have to find out if that's going to happen. But the first part worked to perfection. D did exactly what they wanted, and now their offense has to pay it off.
See if they can get the latter 50%. With a quick lull here, Charles, I want you to tell your Watt brothers story. Derek Watt, of course, now in the league with San Diego, JJ with Houston. They're going to meet each other on November 27th.
Fullback versus defensive lineman. And how great is that going to be? San Diego and Houston. And talking with JJ, I said, what is that going to be like playing against your brother? And he said, all I know is I fully expect him to be the lead blocker on the first play of the game. And I'm going to greet him enthusiastically on that play. He said, because otherwise, if he gets the best of me, that will be my Christmas present, a picture of him blocking me. And I can't have that.
Garoppolo. Left side, it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Now on first down, he'll drop to throw it. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
Before that last pass, two interceptions had already been thrown. And this last one tipped in the air, which means everyone on defense is almost fighting each other in order to get to the football to try and make it a third. Once you've thrown a couple, it's almost like a swarm of bees going after the ball. And in this case, they weren't able to get there before it fell to the ground. When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Garoppolo now. Got a man, it's Amendola. Back now in Foxborough. It's Patriot football, but they trail here as we begin the fourth quarter. And the offense lining up first and 10.
Over.
They slot Gronkowski outright.
All right, here we go. Green.
They'll look to throw now on first down. And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. Second down here after the incomplete pass. Again, he'll drop to throw. Looking left side, and it's complete. And he's brought down after a good game. A big play there for the Patriots. 30 yards.
When the big guy rumbles down the center of the field and he gains leverage on a guy trying to cover him, it is really, really tough for the defender to get through him to make a play on the football. That's why guys love to throw that route down the middle, throw it deep, and let the big guy go get it.
And the defense with their backs against the wall a little bit here as the offense is in the red zone.
Here we go now. Blue 90. Blue 90.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking it. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And it's picked up by the Steelers. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field.
Well, partner, I think it's safe to say they can mark this down as extremely frustrating. Here we are in the fourth quarter, and that last play, that turnover, I think it epitomizes what happened to them all day on offense.
So symbolic, and that's why they're still being shut out. They'll run it with Williams. And he finds some space past the 25 to the 27. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3.
I know that every now and then we get in those meetings with coaches, and you almost want to roll your eyes when they talk about staying on schedule when they're moving the football. But would you say a 7-yard run is ahead of schedule?
Fourth quarter with a lead, you love that, don't you?
No doubt about it, because staying on schedule is trying to get 4 downs on first down. They did that plus 3.
Now a play fake here on first down. Throwing middle, but it's incomplete.
And that one was knocked away, and I think the defenders are going to be a little upset with themselves. They made the play on the football, but that one felt like a forced pass by the quarterback. thought he had someone open. He really wasn't. Maybe an example of having too much confidence in his receiver that no matter what, I'm going to throw it to him. And that was a play made by the defense, and it could have been a bigger one.
Second and 10 now. It's Roethlisberger. Over the middle here to Brown. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. He's played a great game. It continues right there, even with this lead, confident to throw the pass and have the reception made.
There's no doubt who the leader of their team is there? There's no doubt who they want to ride all the way to the finish. The strategy would tell you run the football, run the clock down. Instead, they're letting him throw it because they feel that confident in what he's getting done.
7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3. Now we're going to get a timeout here called by the Patriots. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. On second down, Roethlisberger. And he's going to be sacked back on his side of the field at the 44. Chris Long in there to bring him down for a loss of 7. Now whistles blow and the Patriots are going to take another timeout. That's going to leave them with just 1 remaining here in this fourth quarter.
An extra corner on the field for New England here on third down.
Yeah, another DB. On third down, Roethlisberger. He gets it to Brown, complete. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37. And defensively, they just don't seem to have much of an answer for this passing game.
Not at all. Look at the confidence that's exhibited here. With that type of a lead, clock on their side, instead of running it, they're still throwing it, trying to pick up first downs and keeping the football.
A gain of 3, second down.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. First level defensive line, second level linebackers, third level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a first level run, and it was stopped by a second level player.
Now it's Roethlisberger, and intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. A great read, and it's picked off. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. So the Patriots coming out now, and they'll be looking to atone for last time's mistake of fumbling inside the red zone. Certainly they don't want to do that again.
And so much emphasis placed on red zone offense. I mean, you have periods devoted in practice just for that because everyone knows how vital it is to put points on the board when you've entered that part of the field and to come away.
That's caught at the 25. A big play there for the Patriots. 36 yards. Time for a break. We'll come back to wrap this one up after this. Garoppolo. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was trying to fit it into Gronkowski there, and it'll be second and 10.
How many times when we see an incomplete pass, we just look at the receiver and say, should have caught that one. That was a drop, and we just put it on the offense. How about a little credit for the defense there? They just forced an incompletion.
Yeah, especially. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked off by Mike Mitchell. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. And Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. Looked like they had something going last drive. Then the interception happened. Will they recover?
The memory they need to keep with them is that they did have something going. They were moving the ball on offense, had a nice sequence going. Don't worry about the other part. You can't get that back. Let's go back to what you were doing well before.
I thought you were going to say they need to have no memory, but remember the good part, forget the bad.
I like that even better.
It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. Possible run anticipation here as the D-line sandwiches together. They come out with 1 back and 3 tight ends. Now a man who's been busy this afternoon, it's Williams. Give him 3 yards on the run there. That still leaves him with a difficult 3rd and 8 coming up. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. That'll leave him with just 1 remaining in this fourth quarter of play.
Three.
And if they want to keep this drive alive, they'll need 8 yards here on third down. Brown, the lone receiver left. Roethlisberger. He's got his man here. It's Green. And he's brought down after a good game.
He went full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab. Oh, Roethlisberger going to throw. On the right side, caught by Green. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory.
And there's another completion to the tight end. And let's face it, it is hard to overthrow a 6'6" target.
It is indeed. Quarterbacks like their speed guys. They like that huge 6'6" target that they've got in him.
They really do. And it reminds me of what one great tight end told me once. He had told his quarterback, just make sure you throw it up there. You know, kind of like put up on the top shelf where the kids can't get it.
They go play action here on first down. And his throw here is incomplete. He was trying to find Ladarius Green there as tight end. And that'll make it second and 10.
Normally, he's pretty reliable. Usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. Second and 10. It's Roethlisberger once more. Oh, hit as he throws there, incomplete.
The good signal callers will never go back in the huddle and play the blame game because they need those guys to protect him. But on that last one, his offensive line, they lost their leverage very quickly, and that's why they were able to get to him and hit him as he tried to throw the football and force an incompletion.
To throw again is Roethlisberger. Oh, incomplete. Nearly the pick they needed. They would have loved one there, but at least it does get them to fourth down.
I know that interception was dropped, and it would have been their third of the game, and I will guarantee you, in the huddle, on the bench, all the defensive guys have been talking about is, we've got this guy right where we want him. Who's going to get the next one? It almost becomes a challenge, and they missed a golden opportunity.
And this one is right down the middle. And that will make this now a 15-point advantage. So they settle for just the three there, but clearly anything helps when you're trying to salt one away here in the fourth.
Without a doubt, I think a touchdown would have been the final nail. But three does give them some breathing room and lets them build up a little cushion.
After the successful field goal try, here's Boswell to send it away. Penalty marker is down here. And Charles, this is one of those inexcusable special teams penalties, an out-of-bounds kickoff.
Pressure, pressure, pressure. Sometimes errors occur because of situations.
Watch it now. All right, now. Lock it 56. Lock it 56.
They slot Gronkowski outright.
All right, here we go. Green, 39.
Garoppolo now. He's going to let it fly. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete.
Well, they went for the big play there, but that drop could really hurt their momentum.
And on second and 10 now.
All right, now, lucky 56. Lucky 56. Now, let's go. 319. 319.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now.
My high school coach, John Ford, used to say all the time, if you're in a bad situation, laddie, don't compound it with a bad decision as well. And I think that's what we just saw there. Harassed in the pocket, and he throws into double coverage anyway.
He called you laddie?
He called me laddie, and that was the nicest thing he called me.
And he'll be hit from behind and taken down. Arthur Motes coming in to drop him for a loss of 8, and it'll be fourth down. All right, Charles, so you win the game. Not only do you get the W in the left-hand column, you get some momentum for the coming week.
Now when you go into the week and you're telling the guys what mistakes have to be corrected, what we have to do to win going forward, you have their full attention. They're excited, they're happy, and they know if they can build that momentum, they can ultimately achieve all their goals.
So that'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. And with that, we say so long from Foxborough.